Good morning. Let me begin by thanking the organizers of this symposium for inviting me to give this talk. The topic of today's presentation is a very dear subject to all, and it's about chocolates. The title is Insights into How Thermal and Mechanical Fields Affect the Rheological Behavior of Chocolates. My co-author is a PhD student, Tulika Bhattacharya, who has now become expert in the food rheology. So let us begin by addressing the question, what is chocolate? Molten chocolate is a concentrated colloidal suspension whose continuous phase is cocoa butter, which is nothing but fat matrix of triglyceride chains, which is mixture of palmitic, stearic, and oleic acid, and its chemical structure looks something like this. The dispersed phase is cocoa particles, sugar particles, and milk particles, which is significantly in concentration, about 65 to 70 weight percent, and high concentration of particles and crystalline moieties make chocolate a concentrated suspension. When chocolate is present in molten state at high temperature and we cool it down, during cooling, crystal domain formation takes place. And by virtue of its inherent dependence on temperature as well as crystal domain formation, viscosity of chocolate increases and its state changes from melt to soft solid to hard solid. Crystalline domain formation strongly depends on the cooling rate, equilibration temperature, and the applied deformation field, if any. This behavior is reminiscent of solidification of semicrystalline or amorphous polymers on cooling below their glass transition temperature. Now, the continuous fat phase is known to have different crystallization forms or polymorphs. Typically, six types of polymorphs are known to have for the fat phase. Form 1 to form 4 have double chain packing, while form 5 and form 6 have triple chain packing. When you cool the chocolate from high temperature to low temperature, essentially the form 1 gets formed, and as a function of time, it changes to form 2 to 3 to 4. On the other hand, careful tempering is required in order to get form 5, which with time also gets converted into form 6. Particularly for that specific mouthfeel and taste, it is considered that form 5 is the most desired form of this chocolate. Now, with increase in this particular number, form 1 to form 6, the melting temperature of the respective crystalline domain increases, and of course, therefore, the stability of that particular crystalline domain also increases. How the tempering in chocolates carried out? So typically, you take chocolate melt at high temperature and rapidly cool it to about 28 degrees centigrade, where it is equilibrated, and then it is rewarmed to around 32 degrees centigrade. During this equilibration at 28 degrees centigrade, various types of crystalline domains get formed. And at 32 degrees centigrade, typically the lower crystalline domains, which is nothing but form 1 to form 4, they essentially melt out. The whole process is carried out under shear, which essentially causes higher number of seed crystals, and fatty acid chains align themselves in the direction of shear. So shearing along with rewarming accelerates nuclei formation of form 5, which is actually the desired phase for the chocolate. This brings us to our objective. As we have seen, chocolate gets strongly affected by the temperature change as well as by the shear. So in this work, our specific objective is how thermal and mechanical fields affect the rheological behavior of chocolate. And for that, we use commercially available chocolate, which is Cadbury chocolate silk. So in the first protocol, what we do is we take chocolate melt at high temperature and rapidly cool it to 24 degrees centigrade. And then we maintain it at 24 degrees centigrade, during which we subject it to small amplitude oscillatory shear and examine evolution of dynamic moduli, which is nothing but G prime and G double prime as a function of time. And the typical evolution of G prime and G double prime as a function of time is shown in this particular slide, wherein both the moduli undergo evolution in four steps. Initially, a weak increase, followed by a sharp increase. In the third stage, dynamic moduli pretty much remain the constant up to around 15,000 seconds. And then we get again high increase at very high temperature. If we carry out step strain experiments, if this is strain, if we carry out step strain experiments at different waiting times, then obviously stress will get induced in these particular materials. And we shall be able to study stress relaxation behavior, which we essentially show in the next slide, wherein on the left-hand side plot, the corresponding relaxation behavior can be seen in the left-hand side plot, wherein relaxation modulus decreases with time elapsed since application of step strain. With increase in waiting time, the relaxation modulus curve shifts to higher values, which is suggestive of slowing down of the relaxation dynamics. Beyond TW equal to 4,000 seconds, you can see that the relaxation modulus curves fall on top of each other, suggests slowing down of overall dynamics in that particular time zone. Further insight into relaxation dynamics can be obtained by estimating something called relaxation time spectrum, H of tau. H of tau is defined in such a fashion that H of tau, DL and tau, where tau is relaxation time, corresponds to contribution to modulus from relaxation time modes lying in between tau and tau plus D tau, which means H of T is the strength of the relaxation mode having value tau. We can approximately estimate H of tau by computing this particular derivative. In our study, we observe H of tau to have negative slope. Now, when H of tau has a negative slope, it essentially suggests domination of the faster relaxation modes, or I should say progressive domination of the faster relaxation modes, which is suggestive of a network structure. As shown in this figure, we indeed observe negative slope whose magnitude goes on decreasing with increase in waiting time. As a matter of fact, the magnitude very rapidly goes on decreasing, leading to a fat relaxation spectrum, which means densification of the material. Beyond 4,000 seconds, again, the relaxation spectrum can be seen to be independent of waiting time. We now study the effect of mechanical regeneration, wherein we rapidly cool the chocolate from 60 degrees centigrade to 24 degrees centigrade and carry out aging for 3 hours, which essentially takes material to this level of G prime. And then we subject it to mechanical regeneration as shown in this particular figure. The three mechanical regeneration strains that used in this study are 200, 300 and 500%. We apply mechanical regeneration for 30 minutes. And after that, we study evolution of G prime and G double prime as a function of time. In this particular plot, we show evolution of dynamic moduli for mechanical regeneration with 500% strain. This strain is chosen in such a fashion that the dynamic moduli have very similar value initially to that of after thermal regeneration. However, it can be seen that the evolution of dynamic moduli is much more gradual in case of mechanical regeneration than in case of thermal regeneration, which we observed to be occurring in steps. This qualitatively different regeneration in both cases suggests that thermal and mechanical quench take the system to different sections of energy landscape, despite initial modulus being similar. We also study effect of lower strain percentages, and we observe that with decrease in strain during mechanical regeneration, shifts the curve to higher values of G prime. During this particular evolution, we subject material to different values of step strain in independent experiment, and the corresponding behavior of relaxation modulus is shown in again in the left hand side figure. It can be seen that the relaxation modulus decreases with step time, and at higher waiting times, essentially the relaxation modulus curve shifts to higher values. However, compared to thermal regeneration, here movement of relaxation modulus curves to higher values is again more progressive. We also obtain relaxation time spectra, wherein we observe a negative slope, which is again suggestive of network, but the magnitude of slope decreases much more gradually than in case of thermal regeneration. We obtain relaxation time associated with the material. Essentially here we obtain something called T half, which is the time taken by material to decrease the modulus to its half value. Here the black squares show relaxation time evolution after thermal quench, and you can see that initially there is a very rapid increase in relaxation time with very high values as well, followed by a weak increase. On the other hand, for mechanically regenerated systems, the increase is more gradual, and initially it's weak increase followed by its moderately high increase. You can see here that the evolution of relaxation time also is qualitatively different in case of mechanical regeneration compared to that of thermal regeneration. So, discussion and concluding remarks associated with this study. Owing to multiple crystalline states, chocolate morphology is very sensitive to processing conditions. The present rheological study indicates buildup of network, wherein network could be formed by particulate matter and crystalline moieties. Three indicators: evolution of dynamic moduli, evolution of relaxation spectrum, and evolution of relaxation time after mechanical regeneration are qualitatively very different than that observed for thermal regeneration. Overall, the evolution of the rheological properties is observed to be more gradual in case of shear regenerated systems. Such behavior may be due to effect of shear during regeneration on subsequent evolution of crystalline domains in size as well as in numbers, and their interconnection that eventually affects the chocolate rheology. The implication in commercial products, wherein solidification takes place with decrease in temperature and product is soft enough to get affected by shear. Some typical products could be soaps, peanut butter, jaggery, etc. Thank you for your attention.